वेलकम बैक। In this session, we are going to briefly discuss about a digital modulation technique, the basic digital modulation technique, binary phase shift keying, simply abbreviated as BPSK. We are going to represent the BPSK signal in time domain with the help of mathematical expression and graphical representation. Moreover, we are going to represent the signal constellation diagram of BPSK, which is very useful in deduction process. And also, we are going to describe the process of generation and deduction of binary phase shift keying signal. Generally, binary phase shift keying signal is a digital modulation scheme in which the phase angle of the sinusoidal carrier is varied in accordance with the corresponding binary data 1. So we are having a phase angle of 0 to 2 pi. The range of the phase angle varies from 0 to 2 pi. So the entire range is divided into 2 in such a way that the phase angle is switched between 0 radians per second and pi radians per second. Hence, it is called as phase reversal keying. The carrier signal can be represented as C of t is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT, and we know that AC is equal to square root of 2 EB by TB, where EB is the bit energy and TB is the bit duration. Hence, the binary phase shift keying modulated waveform can be represented as SI of T is equal to square root of 2 EB by TB cos of 2 pi FCT plus theta I. This theta I is the phase angle variation. With respect to the binary data, if the binary data is 1, then theta will be equal to 0, theta I will be equal to 0. If the binary information 0, theta I will be equal to pi. That means for the binary information 0, binary information 1, the symbol S1 of t is transmitted, so cos 2 pi FCT plus theta 1. Theta 1 is equal to 0 here, so it can be written as it is, square root of 2 EB by TB cos 2 pi FCT. For the binary data 0, S2 of t is transmitted, that is square root of 2 EB by TB cos 2 pi FCT plus pi, which is providing minus cos 2 pi FCT. So with these, we can write in mathematical expression such a way that S1 of t, S2 of t is equal to plus root EB minus root EB multiplied by square root of 2 by TB cos 2 pi FCT. Here, this is called as orthonormal basis function phi 1 of t. And the orthonormal basis function is having an unit energy. That is why it is represented like this, square root of 2 by TB into cos 2 pi FCT. Hence, S1 of t can be written as square root of EB multiplied by phi 1 of t, and S2 of t can be written as minus root EB multiplied by phi 1 of t. So, S11 is plus root EB and S21 is minus root EB. S11 is nothing but the correlation between S1 of t and phi 1 of t. Similarly, S21 is the correlation between S2 of t and phi 1 of t. Let us discuss the graphical representation of BPSK signal for the corresponding binary sequence 10101, which is represented by a TB, which is called as bit duration represented in seconds, and the carrier signal is represented like this. And here we can see the phase changes. Hence, for binary data 1, S1 of t is transmitted. S1 of t is square root of 2EB by TB cos 2 pi FCT, which is represented like this. And whereas for the binary data 0, it is reversed. So here it is having a positive cycle. So here it starts with negative amplitude. That is, the negative of the carrier signal is transmitted for the binary information 0. And this kind of signal is called as antipodal signals. For the binary data 1, this information is binary data 1. This symbol S1 of t is transmitted. For the binary data 0, the reversed signal is transmitted. So S2 of t is transmitted. That is called as, these signals are called as antipodal signals, which are all opposite to each other. The signal space diagram of signal space constellation of BPSK is having one dimensional signal space, n is equal to 1, because it is having only one orthonormal basis function. So the number of dimensions here, n is equal to 1, and the number of symbols used here as m is equal to 2. So the correlation between the symbols and the orthonormal basis function is determined by Smn is equal to integral over Tb Sm of t phi n of t dt, where m is equal to 1 and 2 and small n is equal to 1. Hence, the message point for the symbol binary data 1 is determined by S11 is equal to integral of 0 to TB S1 of t phi 1 of t dt. And we know that S1 of t is equal to square root of EB into phi 1 of t. So integral of root EB phi 1 of t phi 1 of t dt, which will provide integral of phi 1 square of t dt over the interval TB, which is nothing but the energy. The energy of the orthonormal basis function is 1 joules. So S11 can be written as plus root EB, which is mathematically proved by the derivation of proper substitution of the values of phi 1 of t in appropriate places. Similarly, for the message point corresponding to the binary data 0 can be determined by the integral expression S21, which is equal to 0 integral over an interval of TB S2 of t phi 1 of t dt, where S2 of t can be written as minus root EB into phi 1 of t, which will lead to minus square root of EB multiplied by integral of phi 1 square of t over an interval TB, which is nothing but the energy of the orthonormal basis function, which is equal to 1 joules. So F21 can be represented as minus root EB. Hence, the constellation map can be drawn in such a way that it consists of only one-dimensional phi 1 of t, and the message point 1 is represented by plus root EB, and the message point 0 is represented by minus root EB. That is, this is S11 and this is S21, and this message point is corresponding to the transmission of the symbol S1 of t. And here it is represented by S2 of t. The generation of BPSK signal is accomplished by allowing the binary message data through a polar non-return to line encoder, in which the binary data 1 is encoded as the positive polarity plus root EB, and the binary data 0 is represented by a negative voltage minus root EB, which is multiplied by a carrier signal phi 1 of t with the help of a product modulator. So if the binary data 1 is being transmitted by the modulator as multiplied by, that is, plus square root of EB phi 1 of t, which is equal to S1 of t, is transmitted when the binary data 1 is coming to the modulator. And if the binary data is 0 is coming to the modulator, then minus root EB is multiplied with phi 1 of t, then S2 of t is transmitted. The detection of BPSK signal is done by the correlator receiver, which is called as coherent receiver. The coherency here is accomplished with the help of synchronizing the phase and frequency of the carrier signal at the transmitter side and at the receiver side. Hence, a binary PSK signal is received as R of t. Let R of t is assumed to be S of t, and S of t is maybe either of S1 of t or S2 of t. The correlator consists of a multiplier followed by an integrator. The multiplier is fed by the synchronized carrier so that the output of the product multiplier is R of t into phi 1 of t, which is fed to an integrator so that the integral value, the output of the correlator R, will be equal to integral of 0 to TB R of t phi 1 of t dt, which is represented here. And this R value is compared with a threshold value. If the R is greater than that particular threshold, then the decision will be taken in favor of the binary data 1. If the R value is less than the threshold, then the decision will be taken in favor of the binary data 0. If the binary data 1 is transmitted, then S of t is, R of t is equal to S1 of t. So R is equal to square root integral of S1 of t, phi 1 of t dt over TB. So that will be equal to plus square root of EB. Similarly, R of t is equal to S2 of t for the transmission of the binary data 0. R will be equal to minus root EB. If the R, if we can assume the system in the presence of additive white Gaussian noise, R of t can be represented as S of t plus N of t, where N is the additive white Gaussian noise. So at this time, here for the binary data 1, R can be represented as plus root EB plus N. And for the binary data, the reception of binary data 0, it is represented by square root of minus EB plus N. So, a threshold is chosen in such a way that by averaging the S11 and S21, we get plus root EB minus root EB by 2, which is equal to 0. So the threshold is chosen at lambda is equal to 0, and the adhesion region is constructed, and the distance between the two message points here as 2 into square root of EB. And if the occurrence of the noise is in such a way that if plus N, if the binary data 1 is transmitted, if it is added, then it is moving here. So there is no problem if the lambda is, if the R is greater than lambda, then we need not to worry about it. If suppose the additive white Gaussian noise is having a destructive addition, that is minus N, then the received point, the transmitted point is at S11, and the received point will be less than this point. So it may occur here, it may occur here, it may occur here, so that if the decision rule should be chosen in such a way that if the received value R is greater than the lambda, then it should be decided in favor of the binary data 1. Similarly, if the received value is less than the lambda, that is the threshold value, then the decision should be taken in favor of the binary symbol 0. And if the received symbol value is 0, that is exactly the threshold value, then the receiver is having a freedom to choose either in favor of the binary data 1 or in favor of the binary data 0 randomly.